And I would like to give you some information about the program that on the base of this approach was developed in Slovakia. So, paradigm is a way how we look on the things. And why we are speaking about new water paradigm? We are speaking because we would like to have a new understanding of water and role of water in our environment. This is why we are speaking about new paradigm. This picture was presented already by Marco, but I would like to say that civilization really changed the continents very, very, very quickly. And because changed the continents, it increased runoff, decreased evaporation, evapotranspiration, and it means this changed climate that way. And after then, bigger influence there is by oceans, and there is more heat on the land, and it make troubles. And we would like to see which kind of troubles there are. Here you can see a piece of the agricultural land, a good example of big problems. Big erosion, no cooling, and big runoff. So we have huge parts of our countries everywhere which are damaged. For example, you can see erosion lines in the forest. And these erosion lines, they are like rivers. They are draining all the forest area from water permanently during the year. And this is the situation once there is no good management. And these parts of environment and of the landscapes, they have troubles later. Classical type of channelization of the water and the river, which is again classical example. If community have troubles with floods, it's up to now water management company in Slovakia provides to community channelization of the rivers. So they will invest 2 million euros in project like this. So they will prepare a river that visible to adopt a lot of water during the flood, but at the same time community which is behind this village has big problem at the same time, because they have a different river, and they don't solve problem. They just put problem to another community. And this is the picture that was already described, that what happened once we change surface cover. So civilization does three basic changes. It decreases vegetation cover, it increases erosion, and it increases runoff of the water. So and this process is somehow like one-way process. And if it is one-way process, it has big influence. And maybe this is explanation of why there is such a big increase of the water in oceans and seas, because there is decrease of water on the continents and in the soil. So we can see direct relations. What does it mean, desertification of the continents and increase waters of the in the sea and oceans? But what is very good is the message. Is the message that was formulated in this new water paradigm, and it is that if we understand this mechanical side of this process, and if civilization really decrease the circulation of the water on the continents and increase these extremes on the continents, but by systematic activity in the landscape, we can reverse this process. But this activity must be really massive. It means it must be done on agricultural land, in forest, in urban land. And if we will be able to do it on massive scale, we will be able to increase amount of the water that circulates on the continents and to decrease these extremes. So that is very positive message. So in this picture say that we have a good chance to influence situation in regions, in water basins, in all in states and continents as well. But activity must be Nasib. A few summarizes. Activities usually in public sector are isolated. There are different ministries, but every ministry is looking on its job. You know, agricultural ministry is looking for agricultural production, environmental ministry is looking for water and nature protection, another ministry of buildings looking for development, but there is very little of synergies, and this is why there is no communication between them. And finally, landscape lose this ecosystem ability to protect, to cool themselves, to cool landscapes, and we create problems with weather. So, new water paradigm. I would like to summarize very briefly, as in some timeline, what happened. This publication and very first ideas about this publication. It was founded and formulated by Michal Kravčík. Michal is in India now on a water conference with some other friends. I know that somebody from France is as well on this conference. And what is very important, Michal was encouraged by Juraj Kohutier, another friend. If you have such idea that how important is water for the ecosystem and for the climate, let's put this idea on the paper. And this is how this group of five people from Czech Republic and Slovakia was formed, and we formulated this this principle, this paradigm. But I can say that many other people participated on formulation of this book because they were involved in the debates before. But what was very interesting, immediately after publication of this book, and this book is available on the internet as well, huge international networking started. So very first contact we had was with Marco Schmidt, and immediately we started to communicate through other countries, states, and tried to exchange experiences. I think within a few months we had contacts on every continent, and somehow we started to promote this concept on different conferences. And we are trying up to now to find a way how to implement this theoretical knowledge into practice. Just few pictures. In 2008, there was a conference in Zaragoza. It was Water Expo. So there was an occasion for a presentation of the approach. I think the same year, Michal Kravčík was presenting this publication to Prince Philip when he was on with Queen Elizabeth second in Slovakia on a visit. And what was interesting, we recognize that this process is very important from point of view of participation. We found that local activities, local communities are, and civic activities are very important for implementing this approach. Why? New water paradigm is saying that every piece of the land, every square meter is important for climate. And if you are owner of the land, if you are community on the local level that have influence on the land, you can contribute with your activities to the improvement of the climate, but you can contribute to the decrease of the risks, flood risks and drought risks. So several other events happened, and we formulated several principles of of integrated water resource management within the civic association, association of towns and communities, where I was working between 2006 up to 2010. And well, that was a nice moment. In 2009 we got some kind of award from Czech Minister of Environment for the team of authors. But what was very important, in 2010, you remember, there was a big problem with floods in Europe, especially in Central Europe. And in that time, we had a lot of damages by floods in Slovakia. And at the same time, new government came to the power. And this new government created conditions for adopting this concept on governmental level. So there was created a special position of advisor to the government. And I was appointed to this position, and on the base of this work within the Association of Towns and Communities in Slovakia and the papers, strategic papers that we developed, we prepared a document which was named Landscape Revitalization and Integrated River Basin Management Program that focused on one specific issue, that if we would like to improve situation in Slovakia, we have to do it by increasing water retention capacity of the landscape. Because water retention capacity everywhere, in every country, over century, is really decreasing all the time by deforestation, by asphalting, you know, roads and everything. So every community lose or lost hundreds, thousands of cubic meters of water retention spaces. This is why the landscape is not prepared to absorb the water and after that to support by water vegetation. So we set up a national goal. This national goal was to increase water retention capacity in Slovakia with volume 250,000 million cubic meters of the spaces. And these spaces, once they will be created in the landscape, they will be repeatedly used by every rain event. So this program really became an economical program, multi-sectoral, and because the government, which took power in 2010, was only 18 months in the power, because after then there was a situation that because of the Greece crisis, there were some debates political, and the parliament decided that this government will not continue. So after 18 months, this government finished its position, and after that, new government came in 2012. But within 18 months, we were able to implement this idea in activities in almost 500 villages and towns in Slovakia. We had some map that was analyzing problems of flash floods and regional floods. And on the base of some very easy selection process, we were able to identify communities that were involved in the program. So you can see distribution of these communities. And in every of these communities that are on the picture, capacity from 5,000 cubic meters up to 50,000 cubic meters of water retention spaces were created in their cadastre. Community got 4 euros per 1 cubic meter created of the space, and from this money they were able to fund local people to pay salaries, to pay fuel and materials, and they were able to create very different structures. And what is very interesting, they used local materials, stone, soil and wood, and usually they created these water retention spaces in problematic parts, in damaged parts, mostly in damaged parts of the landscape. So our experience after doing this measure in the landscape was that if community had problems with floods maybe 2-3 times a year or 4 times a year, after doing these measures, because they were not able to do these measures on all their cadastre, but let's say in 40% of their cadastre, in that part of the cadastre, when they did these measures, they recognized immediately decrease of flood risks, or they had no floods. So we had very positive reaction from people that participated on the program. Approximately 7,700 people were involved in the program, and we had very positive reaction from the people living in that communities, that they really recognized that flood risks were lower. Very different types of the measures, approximately 100,000 different types of structures were created in Slovakia. There was a number of coordination meetings in different parts of regions of Slovakia. They were for discussions, for exchange of experiences, of engineers, of local people, of mayors that were involved in the program, and it was very good school. Finally, this program helps to decrease flood risks, drought risks, and again improve cooling and evaporation. And this program was implemented through 3 projects. in first 23, after then 190, and after then 350 communities were involved in different stages of the program. This publication was published as a summary of what happened during this program, Landscape Revitalization Program in Slovakia. It's available on internet as well. It's Slovak and English translated, so you can have some idea what happened. What is very interesting is that if we see on international level, we can see that a lot of policies on European level as well are saying, yes, green infrastructure is important. Let's water framework directive is saying about better management of water resources. But there is still a big gap between these ideas and between the practice. Publication was translated in Korean language, and there is another meeting with group from England, and another member of that group from England got a prize, World Water Prize in 2015, Rajendra Singh, and it was quite interesting because Rajendra was doing similar work in very dry regions of India, and he, by water retention and renewal of water retention structures in the landscape, they were able to bring water back to rivers, to dry rivers. So people started to come to that region because the region was able to start to produce food, and it was nicer for living. So on the end, I would like just to summarize some benefits and dimensions of this new water paradigm approach application in several points. Environmental dimension, by improving and increasing water retention capacity of the landscape, we are encouraging improvement and the renewal of small water cycles that are distracted. There is really need for recovery of these small water cycles and as well anti-erosion measures and so. But what is very important, if the national goal of Slovakia was 250 million cubic meters of water retention capacity to increase, Michal Kravčík calculated that on the global level there is need for 750 cubic kilometers of these measures that need to be done. So this capacity need to be increased. And you can calculate how much it is probably in your country. Maybe it is 2 cubic kilometers, maybe less. But if you calculate this water retention capacity on the size of your community, it can be maybe 1,000 cubic meters or maybe 20,000 cubic meters. But every community can participate on achieving this goal. There are a number of benefits of having this approach and implementing this approach. Between many of the benefits, there is a benefit that we will grow water resources in the landscape and in the soil as well. Very important is that it is a really holistic process, space in space and time. And if we understand to this process, we are able to improve the situation in the landscape. Economic dimension, we learned that by creating this funding criteria, the maximum 4 euros per one cubic meter of this water retention space created, we found very good way how to support local initiatives on the local level, local landowners, local communities. And within activities in Slovakia, within 18 months, 4% of this national goal was achieved. Economical benefits, this approach decrease losses and damages. At the same time, we have enough public funds and enough funds in the system that can fund this on not only on regional and national level, but on global level. And this approach can be completely, for example, funded by private sector, because it will bring to private and public sector completely new dimensions, socio-economic dimensions, that new regions that are dry now, they can slowly be recovered, and people can return again to these regions because they will become vital. And what is very interesting, a message maybe from my point of view, which is most important, that there need to be a new pillar of the economical policy, economical pillar added to every policy, agricultural policy, urban policy, and forest policy, creation and retention of the water. Because usually farmer is looking what he will sell, you know, how many plants will sell and what will be his earnings. But at the same time, they need to be involved that on their land they will store as much of the rainwater and they will create as much of the green to for this cooling effect. So farmers, urban citizens and managers in the forest, they will be directly involved in this renewal of ecosystem services of the landscape, and they will get financial benefit, because if they will get financial motivation, they will be motivated to do these measures. We learned that by doing this program on local level, we found that local people are able to be trained in these activities. They are able to understand where are the damages of the landscape, how they can identify proper places where to build these measures, and they really can feel that this is their project, so they can really take care of these measures and maintenance for the future. So on the end, I would like to say that this program has, and this approach, very important cultural dimension, because this program say that we need to have different relation to the water. It is not only the rain that is coming from time to time, but it's important that what we do with this rain, and this can help in intercultural dialogue, it can help in building new relation to water, to soil, to vegetation, and on the basis of this, we can create new programs for cooperation, international programs. And for example, if society have today, these months and years, big problems, for example, with immigration from Africa, Middle East, and we see these problems everywhere. I think this is a very nice program to help to different communities where they have really big difficulties, how to rehabilitate their environment, how to help these people to get water on that level. And there is a lot of techniques and technologies how we can implement these measures on a massive scale in different communities. Again, on the beginning it needs learning, exchange of experiences, but such program can have real influence, socio-economical influence and political impact on the future, because it can help decrease risks, including risks of food shortage, yes, and another crisis in the world. So, on the end, we have chance with our communities and our countries to contribute to this solution, because it is assessed, we have experiences, we have different model implementations in different continents, and I think together we can achieve something real. Thank you.